Hi, my name's Ben. I want to talk to you about hemorrhoids.
Let's not talk about that. Let's talk about... Starting off with a plot and story. Now, okay, I'm just going to preface this. This movie gets a lot of hate from a lot of people. And here's what I will say. I don't hate Iron Man 2. I kind of like it. I lean more towards liking it. I don't think it's nearly as good as the first one.
No.
But I still enjoy myself. Now, what I will say, when it comes to the plot, it's weak. The plot and the story are really not great, mostly because they included three different, like, main plot lines and, like, 100 different plot points within those lines that just made it really convoluted.
The movie was crowded.
Yeah.
The excellence that came with the first movie is that it was one flowing story.
Mm-hmm.
With this movie... it's so much more than that. There's too much going on, and it's easy, because it's all happening at the same time. I will say that given what they had, they did a pretty good job.
I would agree with that.
I mean, like, I was entertained the vast majority of the movie, but I was also, like, every now and again something would happen. Like, he would be like, oh, like, Nick Fury would push, stab him in the neck with the antidote or whatever. And I'd be like, oh, right, he had poisoning from whatever's in his chest.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's so much going on.
You forget about, yeah.
You forget about. Every now and again, MC Hammer would come up. Not the MC Hammer, but whatever the other guy's name was, would show up. Hammer.
Oh, Justin Hammer.
Justin Hammer.
Yeah, I was like, who are you talking
yeah.
about?
Yeah, every now and again, Justin Hammer would show up, and I'd be like, oh, he's a part of this movie.
Yeah.
You know, because it's just, there's too much going on. I can't think about it all at the same time.
Yeah. Basically, so you got three main plot lines. You got the main plot line, I think one that takes the most time of the movie, is Tony is slowly dying because of the arc reactor in his chest. This causes a lot of what happens in this movie because he starts to have, like, a midlife crisis of sorts and starts to act really responsibly. Drunk all the time and driving a car in the middle of a racetrack and, you know, making Pepper his CEO of his company.
He's basically preparing to die.
He's preparing to die, and he makes it so Rhodes can take his suit. Like, he does all these things because he thinks he's gonna die. And that's a lot of what happens in this movie, focuses on that plot line. You also got a plot line with Ivan, who is the Russian guy who blames the Stark family for ruining his family's life. He wants to kill Tony, or at least a bare minimum, make it so the rest of the world realizes that Tony can't be killed. And then there's also a plot line of the government wanting Iron Man suits.
Well, and then there's additional plot line where MC Hammer...
Justin Hammer.
Yeah, where he wants to be the new tech company that provides the army with all of these suits.
Right, and I think that's a branch off of the government wanting suits, and that's why
he's
doing it.
Yeah, and it's
it.
Also kind of connecting Ivan with Tony. It's just... there's a lot going on. It's all kind of related, but it's all... I have one note here. It says, story, 2.5, too much.
Yeah, I agree with that. I gave it a 2 out of 5. I think that the story is coherent to a point. It's packed, and it does get a little bit boring at times because of how much they try to throw, and you can't really explore any of it. And for what it's worth, I also feel like they picked the wrong story to focus on. Because Tony dying is not actually that interesting. It doesn't make for that interesting of a story.
Especially since we know that he won't.
Exactly. So if what they really should have done, what the plot line of all those ones they really should have focused on, is Ivan's storyline of wanting revenge. Because
yeah.
He could have been a compelling villain if they'd given him more screen time and more development. But as it is, he gets one fight with Tony, and then he's, like, shunted to the side, where he's doing some mysterious things, but nothing happens from it until the end of the movie.
Right.
And they really blew an opportunity there. I don't mind the plotline of the government wanting suits. I feel like if somebody announced to the world that they owned a suit like Iron Man, then the government would be after it. I think that's realistic. But the one about Tony dying, which unfortunately is the main plotline, it was the weakest thing to try to follow, in my opinion.
I think we're done is the point that he's making. I don't think there's any reason.
The point is, you're welcome,
for
I
what?
Guess. Because I'm your nuclear deterrent. It's working. We're safe. America is secure. You want my property? You can't have it. But I did you a big favor. I have successfully privatized world peace.
The acting and characters of this movie were pretty good. Once again, I have no complaints about any of the acting.
Mm-hmm.
I think that every actor did a great job. I loved MC Hammer. as himself.
Sam Rockwell.
Yeah, and I loved, I didn't hate Ivan. Here's the thing about Ivan. He was playing somebody that didn't speak very good English. And no fault to that, because, like, he did a good job playing that, but it didn't make for a super compelling character.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think that he did a poor job as an actor, but I don't love his character. And that's actually a reoccurring theme throughout a lot of this movie. I think that almost every actor did a good job in the role that they were in.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel like no character was developed as fully as they should have been.
I agree with that. We've already talked about, like, the main cast that continues in this one. Like, Robert Downey Jr. is fantastic as Tony Stark. He always is. Mm-hmm. I will say, if you don't... There's a lot of people that, like, hate the character of Tony Stark. And if you hate Tony Stark, you're especially going to hate him in this one, because he's kind of at his worst in this movie. He's the most arrogant. He comes off as the biggest jerk. Really selfish. Like,
you almost kind of lose a lot of the growth that you saw in the last
first
movie.
One. Yeah, he's at his worst in this movie for sure.
Yeah,
but Robert Downey Jr. Owns it, and he still makes a very likable character to me, at least. I think Tony Stark is my favorite. Tony Stark is the most interesting Marvel character that we have in the MCU to me.
He's the Marvel character that saw the most growth. The rest of the Marvel characters kind of started off as gods and then stayed as gods.
And Tony had a large arc. And I think what I also really like about him is he causes a lot of his own problems and then has to fix them. I think he's just... The amount of flaws that are in Tony as a character make him interesting and compelling to me.
Yeah.
But anyway, so I don't mind that he's not likable in this movie, because I still like him because of his flaws. But...
Yeah, and I will also say, if you look at it from the grander perspective of the entire MCU, this movie... shows kind of the bottom of his character. And then, obviously, the top of his character is when he sacrifices himself to save the world.
Right.
So, if you look at it, the overarching theme, this movie kind of needed to happen so you could see his growth. But it is kind of hard to watch.
Yeah.
It's hard to watch him be in the self-destructive spiral. I don't hate the fact that he was preparing for death. I just hate that his idea of his bucket list, the things he wanted to do before he died... were throw massive parties with bikini-clad women and get sloppy drunk.
Pee in a suit, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But, I mean, at the same time, if you're a billionaire and you've already done everything, then what else is there to do before you die?
Yeah.
So, you know, it's... I don't hate the way that they took it. I don't hate the character. I don't hate any of the actors. I will say this. I gave the movie a 4 in acting and characters, because if it was just acting, I would have given it a 5. But because characters are part of it, and then Ivan's character isn't great, MC Hammer's character isn't great, I don't love Natasha Romanoff, especially yet. She gets better as the series goes on, but in this part...
That was the other thing I wanted to mention. Scarlett Johansson was essentially just the sex symbol in this movie. She had one scene where she got to be...
Cool. Well, she did a couple of cool things. Like, she beat up Happy.
Yeah.
And you always knew that she was a bad A. But she was a sexy bad A, because of course she was. Because can we ever have a strong female character that's not sexy?
Right.
I don't know.
Well, and in this one, it makes a little bit of sense, because she was trying to spy on Tony, and that was the kind of girl that Tony would go for.
Yeah, but, sure. But there wasn't a whole lot of substance to her character.
No, I didn't really care for her. And like Ben said, Ivan and... She and Ivan are really the only ones that kind of take this down a little bit for me. I still love Pepper. Don Cheadle is a great replacement for Rhodey. I like him as Rhodey.
I do too.
I think he does a good job. Justin Hammer, a lot of people don't like him. I think he's funny. I really like him. So
I think that he did a great job in the role of being somebody that tried to be funny and then wasn't.
Right.
And that's hysterical.
Yeah. He's like a wannabe Tony Stark, but clearly a failure at it. And to me, that's funny. That makes for fun.
It's
dynamic.
Really, really funny.
So I also gave acting characters a 4 out of 5. If they had made just Ivan and Natasha a little bit more interesting in some ways, if they'd given them more to do, it probably could have gone up. But I really, acting is a very strong point of this movie. Acting 100%. Characters, 4 out of 5. When it comes to action, here's my thing with this movie. They had some really cool ideas, but they were too short. There's 3 action scenes that I can think of. One is the first showdown between Ivan and Tony, which I really liked, but it was like 2 minutes long.
Yeah.
Because that first part where Tony grabs a suitcase and puts it on and it suits up, I'm like, oh, this is going to be cool. And then it's over right after that. So I wish it was longer. The second scene, which is probably my favorite action scene, is the one where Tony and Rhodey butt heads with the two Iron Man suits in the mansion. I just think that's a cool scene. I don't know why. I think that action was pretty good. Then there's the final battle where Tony and Rhodey are just, like, going down a bunch of drones and fighting, and then Ivan shows up at the very end. To me, this is the longest scene, but it's also the least interesting. I don't think that shooting a bunch of mindless drones makes for a very cool scene.
I agree with that, and I will say that that is one of my biggest problems with the entirety of the MCU, especially the Avengers movies. I am a fan of the Avengers movie. I like the first one especially. I also really liked Age of Ultron, and I liked Infinity War, and I liked Endgame. But every single one of those movies, you get an army of mindless expendables.
Yeah.
And they just have to fight all... And you know that no one expendable is going to be worth the fight. So you're like, why am I watching this? You know, I don't care about this. Now, I will say this about... So that first scene, Tony had been talking a lot about bringing world peace. He said, I have successfully capitalized on world peace. He'd say that all the time. And then he gets attacked, and the world is no longer at peace. Now, I will forgive that scene for being so short, because he needed to nip that in the bud as fast as possible to show the world I can still bring peace, right? Now, I think that their mistake was that they waited so long until they had the next battle.
Yeah.
Because I'm okay with that one being short. It adds to the plot. That's fantastic. Had they thrown in another battle 30 to 45 minutes later, then you would have, and not between Tony and Rhodey. If you had another battle with somebody, whether it be Ivan or MC Hammer, whoever else, a drone from MC Hammer, whoever it is, if you have them fight Tony, and then all of a sudden the world is saying, oh, maybe he didn't bring world peace. Maybe there's something else that we're not seeing here. And that would have added more to the story and more to the action. I agree with Eric in saying that the last scene with all of the drones, not super interesting. And then once again, you get Ivan there, and you have another chance to have a really cool scene between this guy with the whips, because chains and whips do indeed excite him, and Tony and Rhodey, right? So you get two Iron Man versus another Iron Man with long string, and electrocutive string. Electric string?
Electric string. That's what the word you're looking for.
Yeah,
electrocutive. Sorry, Mom.
And so that, so you're like, you're building up to this possibility of having a great scene, and then it just ends. And that's something that happens a lot in this movie, and it kind of bogs it down. The action didn't look bad, but it wasn't super interesting. So I had to give it a 3 out of 5.
I also gave it a 3 out of 5. I do like the way it looks. I just wish they'd made it longer, they had more of it, and it was more interesting to watch. The one that stands up to me again is the battle scene between Tony and Rhodey, probably just because of just the friends butting heads. It was a cool drama
and
scene.
And it feels heavier than the rest of
them. Yeah, I think that's probably why I like it. But yeah, overall, like, it's good. It's just not great.
I told you to shut it down. Fight!
Now, put that thing back where you found it before someone gets hurt. Sorry, pal, but Iron Man doesn't have a sidekick.
So cinematically, this movie was fine. Some parts of it were really good. Some parts of it not as good. I think that I'm a little harsh on this movie with cinematics, because the first movie cinematics were significantly better, it felt like. The music felt unoriginal in this one. I don't know why. Maybe they just didn't play his song enough. And then for the rest of it, it didn't feel that great. His suit-up scene was really cool the first time, and then after that, we never really got another cool suit-up scene. And so, like, that didn't really... I don't know. I think that the biggest thing about Cinemax is right now I'm having a hard time talking about it because it's been 2 weeks and I don't remember anything.
Yeah.
And I feel like if it was good, I would have remembered it.
I actually really do love the cinematics of this movie, and I'll tell you why. This is one of those movies that just looks really good to me.
It does have lots of bright colors.
It has a lot of bright colors, and then just there's some things like his suit-up scene, which was just really cool. There's the scene... where he's playing with the holograms, and that looks really good to me. Like, I think that was really cool.
It was really cool, especially at its time.
Yeah, especially for its time. So, like, that scene stands out to me. The scene where he's sitting up stands out to me. The things he can do with the Iron Man suit stand out to me a lot. I, like, the set, the expo looks really good to me. Like, everything just looked really good. I'd agree that the score is not quite as memorable, but I still enjoy it quite a bit. I don't have any issues with the Cinemax's movie at all. I gave it a 5 out of 5 on a Cinematic scale. I thought it was really good.
I did not give it a 5 out of 5. I had given it a 3.5, and that was right when I had watched it. There's one thing that I want to say, and this is a writing gripe that I have with this movie, and I always had. And I understood it a little bit better this time than the first couple of times I had seen it, and that is that Tony sees a scale model of a utopia, and he sees the planet in the middle, and he says, I can make an atom out of that. Or I can make an element out of that.
Mm.
And I saw that and I said, that's weird. How did you get there? What inspired you with that? Now, this time it does talk a little bit about how the dad had placed things in a specific order so it would look like the neutrons and electrons orbiting and then inside of the planet. I guess that's where the electrons were. But it still seemed like a massive stretch. They were just like, we need to have Tony find a cure, but we can't make it easy on him.
And they want to show how smart he is.
Sure.
Yeah.
But, I saw that and I was just like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know about that. Anyway, I gave it a 3.5. The cinematics in this movie are not bad. They are well above average. They're just not... They're not perfect. They're not as good as the last movie, and they're not as good as movies to come. So I feel like... I don't know. I don't have a ton to say about it, to be honest. I will say it looked good. And it felt heavy in certain places. But honestly, the feeling of the movie, the tone during the fights wasn't as good as I'd like it to be, with the exception of probably the first one. So,
yeah,
3.5. It's not a bad score.
Sarah! I'm going to have to ask you to exit the donut.
On an entertainment scale, this is a movie that is... I really am entertained by certain scenes in the movie, but there are stretches where I'm very much not entertained. Mostly, I will say this. I'm entertained from pretty much from the beginning of the movie until Nick Fury shows up for the first time. And then from that point on, I'm a little bit bored. It kind of loses me after that. Mostly because, like, it's mostly because of how much stuff was going on, and they kept switching back and forth between things, and I just, at that point, I think I was just tired of it, and I just kind of wanted it to be over. This is a movie that I can very much watch, or like rewatch, but I need time between the viewings. The first time I watched this movie, I loved it. Like, I remember very vividly watching this first time. Like, this is so good. This is as good as the first one, or if not better. It does not hold that standard anymore to me at all. It has not aged particularly well, but it's not... I don't... Like I said in the beginning, I don't dislike it as much as a lot of people do for whatever reason. On an entertainment scale, I would give it a 3 out of 5. I think it's, for the most part, entertaining. It does have its dry spots. And it's... not as good as the first one, and it's not as good as a lot that comes after it, which is why it hasn't aged that well. But if you look at it as its own movie, I would say it's entertaining enough to watch.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I think that as a whole, the movie feels long.
Yeah.
Which is not... The ideal movie is a long movie that doesn't feel long, where you get out of it and you're like, wow, no time has passed, but it's actually been like 2.5 hours. With this movie... it feels longer than it is.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember exactly what the runtime was. Maybe I'll flash it on the screen. Maybe I won't. I don't know. You don't know me. But anyway, it feels like a 3-hour movie. I felt like I was there for a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing that I'll say about it is at no point was I bored, but there was several points where I was ready for it to be over.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not great for your movie either. So I gave entertainment a 3.5, which actually makes my average score a 3.3.
And I gave it a 3.4. It's a good movie. I think Iron Man 2 is a good movie. It gets a lot of hate because it doesn't hold up next to a lot of what the rest of the MCU is. But if you just go back and watch this without the rest of the MCU in mind, I think you'll find it's not as bad as you remember it being. Or maybe you would like it less if you haven't watched it in a long time and you remember liking it a lot. It probably is a little bit worse than you remember it being. But to me, this is one that I would recommend seeing. It's one that I enjoy. It's not one of my favorites, but it's a good movie.
Yeah. So if you put our scores together, then we get a 3.35, mm-hmm. which is a pretty good score. Definitely worth a watch. Yeah. If you've never seen the movie, go watch it. What are you doing?
Just right. go watch Iron Man 2. Why just go put on Iron Man 2. Come
look,
on.
It's not hard. Yeah. Right? Just
go to your local library. Go on Disney Plus.
It's on Disney Plus. Yeah. All right. You can probably find clips of it online. Just put them all together. Just watch
just
the movie.
Just watch the movie.
Okay.
Yeah.
And while you're at Walmart picking up the movie, get yourself some Preparation H. All right. It's just always a good idea to have. You never know when the hemorrhoids are going to strike, is what I'm saying. Anyway.
Why are you on the hemorrhoid kit? I don't know. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Tune in next week for 2011's Thor. So we will see you guys next week. Bye.
Ciao.